I, Ayushi, a grade 7 C studying in Delhi Public School, Bengaluru East, is going to show you a new experiment using Arduino. So, this experiment, we are going to find the level of water. And we are going to use a Arduino board, sensors, jumper wires and USB cable, and even we need glass full of water. So first we'll start with the connections. For that, before that, we need to know which sensor we need and the jumper wires. So you can see here, I have three different groups of jumper wires. The first group, this one has a pin on both the sides. Such a wire is called, the pith pin is called male. So this is also male and this is also named male. So we say male to male. In the second group, you can see it doesn't have a pin. This is called female. So this is female, this is female. So this jumper wire is called female to female. In the last group, this wire has a pin and the other side is a non-pin. So this is male and this is female. So we can say male to female. So, in this experiment, we need a female to female and a male to female. So, let's remove this male to male. Now, you can see I have two different sensors. This sensor is called soil moisture detector. And this is another blue sensor which we are going to use with the soil moisture detector to find out the water level. This sensor is used not only with soil moisture, we also use it to find air humidity, light intensity, etc. For now, we are going to use with the soil moisture sensor to find the water level. Now, let's start with the connections. Take your Arduino Uno board . Now, take your soil moisture detector. Take a female to female jumper wire connected to the first one on the soil moisture detector. Now take here the blue device connected to the first pin of it. Take another female to female jumper wire connected to the soil moisture sensor, also connected to the second pin of this blue device. So this blue device, you will get it with the soil moisture sensor. Now let's connect this to the Arduino. So take a male to female jumper wire. So you can see there are four pins: VCC, ground, DO, AO. What are these pins? So VCC means voltage common collector, GND means ground, DO means digital output, AO means analog output. So in this experiment, we are going to use analog output. This is because analog is very easy and simple. If we use digital output, it would be quite tough. Now take your jumper wire, connect the female part to VCC. And now on your breadboard, you can see there are two VCC pins which we can connect to. There is one 5V and 3.3V. 5V means 5 volts and 3.3V means 3.3 volts. So let's connect it first to the 5V. We are not using 3.3V in this experiment. Now take the another male to female jumper wire connected to ground, which is GND. And now you can see there are two ground pins. You can choose any one. But remember, there is a ground pin over here as well, but you should choose the one which is beside the VCC. The 5E, there are two, one, you can choose any one. Now take the last jumper wire, male to female. You can see here we have DO and AO. As you all know, AO means analog output, which is analog is very simple. We are using AO, not DO. You can see here it is written analog in. This means that AO, A1, A2, A3, A4 and A5. These all are analog pins. Over here they are digital pins. As we are not using digital output, we don't want it, so we will not use these. We'll use from here. So now you can choose anyone. You can choose AO, A2, A3, A4, A5. But I am choosing A5 this time. Wow, we are done with our connections. Just need to connect this USB. Now connect the USB cable on the Arduino. So now our connections are done. Let's put it aside. Now let us go on the code. So this is the code. This small code means that over here the function will begin. Over here we are describing a variable val, which means analog read. As we are choosing analog output, we are not writing digital over here, we are writing analog. So now as I connected to A5, I wrote A5 over here, so it will say the water level in this one. So now serial print. So now the pin value means the water level, so it will print the pin value. Then we are writing here val, the variable, so it will show the number of that water level. Then delay of 2 seconds, and this infinite loop will continue. Now let us connect it to the laptop or desktop, whatever you have with you. Look over here, you can see a red light. This red light means all your connections are good. Now first over here you can go to tools, you can see serial monitor option, you can click that, or else over here you can see serial monitor, you can open this also. Before that we need to upload. Let's upload. Wow, it's done uploading. Now let us go to our serial monitor option. It's showing a pin value 1023, but we didn't keep it in water. As we didn't keep our small moisture sensor in water, it will show any value. Now let's keep it in water. Always remember, hold over here, don't touch the small moisture sensor, or else you'll get a shock. Oh, you can see here there is a green light. This green light means the soil moisture sensor is able to take the water level from the soil moisture detector. Look here, if I keep only one pin, it's not showing any green light. This is because it's compulsory to put both the pins. Wow, you can now, let's go to the code. You can see it's showing different numbers. Now how will we find the value, exact value? This will happen because we are using soil moisture sensor, which will say multiple pin value. You can take the first 5 and take the average of that. That will be your water value. Thank you. Hope you like my experiment. You also try and it would be a success. Bye bye.